With its hands in so many cookie jars, Google must be hungry. Not satisfied to dominate search alone, it's competing against Microsoft with apps, against Facebook with Google Plus, and now against Apple and Amazon with the big release of Google Music. Should you bite? Hi, I'm Elsa Wenzel, and first off, with free storage, Google Music is cheaper than both the $20 Amazon MP3 and Apple's $25 iTunes Match, which each include 5 gigabytes of free storage. With Google Music, you can store 20,000 tracks online, not counting what you buy from the Android market. By comparison, iTunes Match has a 25,000 song limit, while Amazon's Cloud Drive offers unlimited storage for uploaded MP3s, plus 20 gigabytes of space for other files. Although Google Music has you buy tunes via the Android market, the MP3s can play on Android and Apple iOS devices, as well as PC browsers. You will pay 69 cents to $1.29 per song. And Google's stepping in where MySpace once ruled. Musicians will be able to pay $25 to promote and sell their songs, keeping 70% of earnings. No surprise, Google lets you share songs with friends on the Google Plus social network. That can include full songs and full albums. Trying to sweeten the deal, Google will give away a bunch of free popular music in the upcoming weeks. However, being a latecomer to the music scene, Google Music has a ton of work ahead to keep up with iTunes, which has sold some 16 billion songs. Google offers 8 million songs for sale, set to rise soon to 13 million, but zilch right now from the Warner Music Group. iTunes already has 20 million tracks, and Amazon MP3 has 17 million. That's not to mention Google's competition from free or subscription streaming services like Spotify and Pandora, or even Microsoft soon. I'm Elsa Wenzel. Thanks for watching.